She must be eating something.
This is my favorite class.
What do you think you're doing, Ryoko?
Huh? Well, I'm having my early lunch.
Yeah, right. And since when does a high school girl's early lunch include sake, huh?
Well, since today, I guess.
Miss Ryoko!
You want some, too? Here.
Oh, great, thanks!
Hey, now, no need to be so uptight, miss. Just have a sip as a token of our friendship. Okay, we're gonna cross the galaxy all the way to planet your eye.
Ryoko, you've got some nerve drinking at a time like this!
I see the no-smoking sign, but I don't see a no-drinking sign anywhere.
You're just a drunkard!
What's your problem?
Hello everyone, this is Kozmic Kitsuneame, and today's live talk video is going to be about this whole quarter life crisis thing. And to be honest with you, the reason I wanted to talk about this is because I've seen and experienced quite a lot in my life. And sometimes when I see these videos on the internet of people, especially Gen Z, talk about how they have no friends, how they're depressed or sad. On one hand, I'm able to get it, but on the other hand, not to knock their videos, there is a element of humor to it as well. Recently, I had some really crappy news happen to me. And one of my friends whom I've known since childhood was very upset by my reaction to this, to which I had to explain to him, you know me well enough to know this is not a cope nor a flex, it's just how I'm choosing to grieve or mourn, as you say. Because another one of our friends, our childhood friends, he is pretty much on his way out. And I was able to, at the very least, enjoy what time was left. You know, when you have family, friends, or people that genuinely care about you, it doesn't matter if they move. It doesn't matter how long you've seen them or how long you haven't seen them. They are going to be there for you. Or when they are around, it's like they never left. In the same way, you should try to be available for them. Now, life happens. People have family issues. People get sick themselves. Imagine not feeling well yourself, having virtually nobody know this, and then having to maintain some sense of normalcy despite all of that. And this video, well, the story I'm about to tell may not fix all of one's problems in regards to that crisis, but I hope that those listening to this will at least get something from this. Before I get into this story, I just want to show this clip because, honestly, as you get older, it doesn't mean that you don't feel pain or that you don't feel sad. It just means that you are choosing the best way for you to handle the situation. And if you don't like how something's going, where you're at, you do everything you can, physically or emotionally, to mitigate that or make it better or whatever you decide to do, but you have to be consistent with that. To lack consistency, to me, is the gateway to insecurity. Because when you reach that point, all hope just seems meaningless. And we've all been there. I would argue that it's probably worse when you're younger. Because you're trying to figure out the world. You're trying to figure out who you are. Trying to figure out your place in it. Those are some heavy hitters to deal with. And so often, whenever I had anyone bring the question to me, or bring that type of energy to me, it often looks like this to me.
I have lost.
Aw, come on now. There's still one tact you haven't tried.
May I have the pebble, please?
Sure.
I am most confused. If you were just going to give me the pebble, why make me go through the whole showdown?
Two reasons. One, it was funny.
True.
And two, to teach you something. If you're going to defeat Wuya, you can't go at her head on. You'll have to try something unexpected. Give me the pebble.
How did you do that?
Omi, you can do a lot of things when you're a Grandmaster Shaolin Dragon. You'll see. Someday.
Grandmaster, I cannot open this box.
The box will open when the person who needs it to open opens it.
I know. This kind of stuff drives me crazy, too.
It'll work when it needs to. Trust me.
Very well. And now, with my mission complete, I must return to the future! Which I have no idea how to do.
Whoa, whoa, Omi! Calm down! Now tell me what's wrong.
Fortunately, I had Grandmaster Dashi, greatest of the Shaolin Dragons, there to help me. Surely he would have an answer.
Sorry, kid, but I don't have any time-traveling Shen Gongwu.
Well, not anymore.
You know, they say a little bit of kindness goes a long way. And I'd like to believe that. However, given how needlessly disrespectful many people are to each other nowadays, I don't know. When you're growing up, either your family or your parents try to do, or rather they should, try to do their level best to prepare you for the world. People often get caught up with how they should be treated, and sometimes they lose sight of how they should treat others. And I've said this in a previous video, and I'm gonna say it again. Just because you haven't earned somebody's respect doesn't mean you've magically earned their disrespect. And I've had to tell quite a few people that over course of my life. Don't waste your time being respectful to people who are going to come at you crooked. There was a point in time, especially when I was a kid, that I truly believed that, okay, this is the proper way to do this, and, you know, that whole save face thing. And I don't really agree with that sentiment anymore, due to the simple fact that there are many different ways to accomplish a goal. Sometimes family or parents, forget that. They're teaching you their way, but you still have to cultivate your way or put a spin on that to make it your own. Because when you don't do that, or you're trying to live up to something, or live up to a standard that in some cases you could never achieve, it can actually set you back. And you have to be able to operate under what is natural and true to your nature. Within reason, of course. And even though it can be very repetitive, very tedious, it's less to do, in my opinion, with the discipline as it does the blueprint itself. There are some people that didn't learn a sense of responsibility until they were damn near an adult. And then there are some kids who always practically had those responsibilities as soon as they were able to walk. So there's always going to be a disconnect due solely to that.
Straighten up.
Yes, Master Shifu.
Wider. Lower stance. Hold your ground. Steady. Strong. Chin up. This is the way of Kung Fu.
I can't even tell them apart.
Focus. Control. Control.
Ah, there she is.
What are you doing? That's not proper form. This is not control. And stand on your feet.
I'm sorry, Master. I don't know what got into me. I won't let it happen again.
I wish I could believe that. 100 laps.
Yes, Master Shifu.
Higher knees.
Yes, Master Shifu.
She wants to make you proud.
Well, maybe I could be proud if she was doing the correct form.
Your form?
Is there another kind?
Shifu, an acorn can only become the mighty oak, not a cherry tree. You must let her grow into what she will be.
The thing that really makes me laugh a bit is this. When you're around people that want the best for you, even if they're in competition with you, hell, even if they don't like you or elements of your personality, they still wish you the best. They still think about ways that you can improve yourself or help the situation. Like, hey, I don't care about this particular thing, but I know you do. What do you think of this? Have you tried this? Why not go there? Having people like that around you can teach you different ways of doing things, and then you ultimately learn your way of doing things. The problem is, the older we get as people, the more set in our ways we get. So that's kind of unavoidable. Sometimes people get so caught up with the way they do things that they can't see anything else outside of that. And truth be told, that's also a form of defense too, and a very healthy one to have. Because if something doesn't yield anything, or you see the flaws or dangers in it, it could be very valid to tell someone, hey, you messed up. But when you're able to see some good come from it, then you might end up changing your mind about it. Or you might not. That's also a choice. Because when I think about what I learned and the time I spent, I wouldn't trade that for the world. Because your experiences, what you learn, how you grow, how you move, That shapes who you are. And it wasn't until later that I started to get out of that, and I guess have my own little rebellion, as some would say. I rebelled, but weirdly enough, quietly or respectfully. It was a respectful rebellion. But yeah. I credit a lot to my parents, but also to the people that kept me in check. I had to check them a couple of times too. Funny enough. But you don't learn who you really are until you have that type of adversity. And for better or worse, you decide that. And I remember me and my friend almost got into a fight, funny enough. Reminiscing. Because he was mad about the situation. And I made a joke that I guess pissed him off. And I know I've said this in previous videos before, and please don't misquote me, but a lot of people need to learn to relax a bit. I know it's hard, I know it's nerve-wracking, but sometimes that person who keeps telling you to relax is telling you that not just for your sake, but for theirs, because they don't want to get into it.
We could check real estate offices today.
Yes, guess we could.
What? You're sad because you got a smaller piece of bread?
Huh? Did you eat the rest?
Wonder what they're doing at home. What do you think, Aika? I think the house must be quiet and really lonely without us. He's around here, I know it.
Susami is at the Jirai Royal Palace, and Kioni and Mahoshi are at the Science Academy.
And we're on the road.
Yeah?
It's been a while since we fought like this.
Yes, it has. Thank you for trying, Ryoko.
Stop it.
Life's too short for that. Hell, some would argue it's too damn long. And the older you get, the less you really want to split hairs with somebody. Yeah, the world's going to shit. We all see it, we all know it. What matters is what you do from here on out. Also, I really hate the term adulting. Ever since I heard that word just... God, that's annoying. Some of this new lingo really doesn't sit well with me. But I'm not the one that gotta deal with it nor live with it. Just something to consider. But you know, sometimes, metaphorically, you gotta perish in order to live. There's parts of yourself you have to let go or get rid of because it's not serving you any good. People grow, people change, you're always changing. There's some people from my past that say, hey man, you changed or whatever. And I kind of chuckle to myself and I say to them, no, I haven't changed. I was always going to be this way. It just took me a little longer to reach that point. I grew into ultimately who I was going to be. May not have been what I wanted to be or even how I wanted to be it, but I am here. I don't let people walk up to me and try to give me an origin story. And you sure as hell shouldn't let somebody come up in to your house or be around you that is going to do this weird thing where they try to make you feel less than who you are. The world's already going to do that. So why the hell would you walk around letting other people do it? Now, I'm not saying go out there and start throwing haymakers. But I am saying, you know, this is something you got to be aware of. And some people just have a messed up attitude. Maybe they have a valid reason to have one. I don't know. Who knows until they talk about it. But yes, I will agree. Life is very hard. It's even harder when you're arrogant as hell. So some people like playing the game on hard mode. Met a few people throughout my life that pretty much put the game on heaven or hell and never looked back. But I try to be thankful for the peaceful days that I do have, because you don't want to live every day in some snow globe of drama. No escape, no nothing like that. Somebody come up, rattle that, and then boom, just stuff go to hell. Cause a storm and a teacup. As I get older, people often get on me and say, oh man, you're animated one minute, but you're introverted over here. It's the way I've always been. I keep to myself. Don't really mess with nobody. And yeah, there's a con to that. It'd be nice to be able to engage in small talk more, but due to the way our culture is, that can be very difficult sometimes. I once had my life threatened just because I told someone Happy New Year. Or a nice car or something like that. And then people walk around doing this and they wonder why nobody wants to talk or say nothing. Because you have a bunch of people that are so over the top, mean-spirited, what's the point? But everyone goes through these stages in their life. And I really don't think the term, I mean, I get a midlife crisis, but quarter life crisis, and I'm not knocking the term, it's just I consider these to be different stages of your life. It's not as if everyone is going to go through that. A lot of people do, but it's not like this thing, oh, I turned this age, now I'm going to start having this. I'm going to start having this mindset, Starting now. You can't pre-plan life like that. You don't know how you're gonna feel in the next 10, 20 years. Hell, you might not even know how you're gonna feel in the next month. Or the next week. You just hope that it will get better. And if it doesn't, you have to prepare for that too. I never really liked it growing up when people would give false hope. Because just because something can get better doesn't mean it will. And just because it hasn't gotten better doesn't mean that it won't. Life only happens once for each and every individual. You could either spend that life trying to find yourself, or you could just spend your life just living it. And I really don't like the term, and maybe it could be because I'm a little older, but when I first started hearing the term living my best life, that confused me a little bit, because I'm thinking, what do you mean best life? You got multiple? We got multiple of these things? I thought it was just one. I mean, I'm not living my air quote best life. I'm just living my life and trying to make it as good as I can. It's not really a, I don't consider that some type of haiku action or something like that. Some battle action. You know, when I was younger, some of the very hobbies that a lot of people enjoy today, they were very niche. And I did a lot of things. I didn't let that hold me back. And because of that, yeah, I got some crap for it. Not gonna lie. But I kept at it. And then, when I didn't feel like doing that anymore or found a new hobby, I just kept adding to the list of things I could do. I'll always have a passion for that. In fact, one of the most annoying things, and I wish people wouldn't do this because I notice this is very, very popular nowadays. Me and my friend almost got into a fight over it. And I've been knowing him for many years. Never had much of a complaint about any joke that I made or any hobby that I had, but then proceeds to ask me, why do you like this? Well, I've always liked this. You used to enjoy this hobby too. And he's like, well, yeah, but I grew up. So when you grow up, you have to stop doing everything you love to do. Because of what again? And he says responsibilities. Well, me and you both have that. In fact, given my situation, I'm lucky I have time to do much of anything at the moment. So, your point? And you know, I try not to get mad, but it's really annoying when someone goes out of their way to not get something. Sometimes it can be confused or being divisive, but maybe the person just genuinely doesn't get it or went over their head. Every hobby is gonna have its drawbacks or the weirdos that hop onto it, but that doesn't take away from what it's actually about. Or what it should be about. And if you hated this type of action, or the actions of the ones going against it, then we can talk about that. But don't try to use that as some type of leapfrog attack to develop some kind of weird metaphorical silver bullet to go after somebody else, because then you'll get checked. And I've never seen a scenario where someone and get checked for that. Like what you like, do what you do. You really don't have to explain it. But it is very annoying when someone tries to twist what you say and throw your words back in your face. It makes the entire conversation about it utterly meaningless because they're just desperately searching for a means to attack or belittle you for it, or attack the hobby as a whole over a small inconsistency in it. Something that most people acknowledge is a dumb thing, but what are you really going to do about it? Are we going to stop enjoying it because a couple of weirdos did something? And if so, what are you going to replace it with? And this clip shows what that looks like, because when you have a passion for something, it's not so much about the competition. I mean, yeah, they're fun, but you should do what you want or like to do for the sake of it. Don't become so obsessed with winning all the time. I know it's hard if you're competitive, but gotta have a drawback on that some point. Kind of reel that back in.
Oh, look at that. That's the best place in the world to be, in the tube.
Really?
Better than winning. The trophy, all that stuff.
Tube riding is the ultimate thing in surfing, to ride inside the wave and make it out of it. It's all we want to do every day.
Oh, it's almost impossible to describe. There's nothing I can compare it to.
It's a feeling that you know not too many people will experience, and so it's special in that sense.
And then you just try to remember it. You're like, geez, I wish I could remember that, or I wish I could get that again. It's just so addicting.
Yeah, once you get inside, you never want to get out.
It's amazing.
Oh, yeah, man. Nothing like it.
Okay, so that aside, how many points would you get for getting tubed? Like, what does it depend on for the contest?
Is
it
points?
What?
You know who you sound like right now?
I promote happiness! Can you see the happiness emanating from me? What's wrong with you?
Alive.
Oh, good, good.
I have to say, I have no doubt that this year's Big Z Memorial is going to be just the best ever.
With that being shown, the reason I mentioned hobbies is because you have to have some type of passion. That's a large part of it as well. Even if you don't land the socialization part down, have something that you genuinely enjoy enough to where, whether you're with others or by yourself, you're good. You're able to fill in that time slot of that void. The last thing you ever want to do is just exist for the sake of existing, because that's not living at that point. So, these crises, as somebody might put it, yeah, they're stages, but it's also just having lack of exposure. Don't worry about where the hell you need to be or where you're gonna be. Worry about being in that moment and deciding, you know what, I'm gonna work towards where I want to be. And even if I don't make it, well, damn. At least you did something. Which is ironically more than most people are now willing to do. You get people nowadays that really just want to pose at something. And I think that's what kind of irritates me, even though I don't vocalize my irritation often about this. I grew up with people like this. They'll be constantly shouting out, you know, the top champions or something. I'm like, okay, you like this person, why don't you participate in this on any level? Because it didn't mean much to them. Maybe it was something they just jumped on, decided to jump off. Who knows? But sit there and try to do that, it's not cool. I actually knew somebody like that. And this was part of the reason why my friend got pretty irritated at me. It's like, you know, you stopped hanging around everybody else for almost about somewhere between 6 to 8 years or whatever. And half of what you just said to me about my hobby, I know about 90% of that came from the creature. Oh, I'm sorry, person you decided to lame with and spend the most time around. You know, just because somebody respects your choices don't mean they have to like them. Don't mean they have to sit there and like them. And I think that's the problem as well. You got people that are so damn cliquish that even if it's something negative, they can't, you know, go beyond that. So, how in the hell someone gonna really feel that if you have to have whole categories for this? Imagine someone wakes up like, oh, these are the friends I play video games with. These are the friends I go bowling with. These are friends you run off and get high with or something. It's like some Jack and Jill type of shit, you know. It's not really a way to live, I mean. Granted, not everyone's going to have a diverse palate in terms of interest. But at least be open to the idea. I've listened to hobbies and things that I don't necessarily care for or I didn't think I'd care for. I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. Now I'm interested in it. It was just never presented to me in that way. Or if I'm not, I'll still listen because I know it's important to the person that's talking about it. That's it. But moving from that, it's a combination of a lot of things. And every generation has its problems. If I had to give a short list of this, yeah, the boomers that were seen and not heard, essentially, by their parents. And then you had Gen X, who got completely stepped over. They weren't really seen, period, or even acknowledged in many cases. Then for some weird reason, a lot of millennials came along, and then everybody was in their shit, in our shit. Yeah, so concerned with, oh, what's so-and-so doing over there? Whatever the hell I want to do. Well, you should be doing that. I mean, it's like some weird helicopter shit. Which is a bit odd. And now Gen Z comes along and they got their own struggle. I really think the struggle, or I don't even like calling it that, but the issue is like, on one hand, there's like an abundance of freedom. Or an abundance of things one can do. And on the other hand, it's like a limited amount of freedom. Like abundance on one end, limited amount of freedom on the other. Can't do this. This might be dangerous. Dangerous to go over here. Damn, can't go nowhere. And if you do go over there, it's like practically having a whole planet or something to you, off to yourself. A whole island off to yourself. And so, yeah, that is going to cause that. And I genuinely do feel bad because a lot of people around my bracket, most of the people we knew we grew up with, whether we spend time together or not, that's just the way it was. And so it doesn't really bother us as much due to the simple fact that when you spend years not having really much privacy yourself, and when you get a little old, you start to get a little bit of that. You become a little cool with it. You become more adaptable to that. Doesn't mean you don't, you know, desire to talk to people, but that's what that is. And as to why there isn't enough people willing to be straight up about this, I have no fucking idea. I really have no freaking clue why they are carrying on like that, trying to say, hey, you know, get this and you'll be happy. No. You'll be happy once you find something to make you happy, but, you know, you kind of have to make yourself happy too. It's kind of the whole thing. There's no cheat sheet to that, you know. You gotta ride the wave on that one. And as for my friend, he will be missed. I'm sure my other friend gonna mourn in his own damn way or cap in his own damn way, but he will be missed. Remember what people stand for and value them while they're here. Because once they're gone, that's it. So, those are my three reasons why I think a lot of that's happening. Lack of socialization, lack of actual hobbies or places to go, and then the other thing is just time and money. We're not exactly in the best of shape in regards to that. You have to have that as well to be able to do that. And you know, there's gonna come a time where people get kind of sick of it all together. Just live the way you want to live and just call it a day. And provided it's within reason, people say what they want to say. You know, I sometimes laugh because one time I remember, it wasn't even that long ago, dude got on me because he's like, well, he's trying his best. I'm like, yeah, here's the problem with this. I tend to laugh at people who try to engage in competition with me when I'm not even a contender. Because one of the most embarrassing things in the world is, let's say me and somebody get into it, and we just really start cussing each other out. And then, for better or worse, whether I'm in the right, whether I'm in the wrong, whatever, I'm like, hey, my bad, shake hands, whatever. Let's just let this particular instance go and move on with our damn lives. You and me are not going to agree on this particular thing. We clearly damn near about to battle over it. Let's just screw it. There's tons of other things. We could be pissed at each other later. This is not that deep, nor is it that important. Let's keep the ball rolling on that. Some people, they don't do that and they escalate. And so naturally, I laugh about that. In fact, this clip actually shows my general reaction to that because I don't miss a beat on it.
Oh my, he's really sweating his guts out, isn't he? Oh, the power of youth. Hey, where are you going? Aren't you going to give him some words of encouragement? That man is repulsive, isn't he? He knows poor Sena hasn't undergone body enhancement yet.
The GP is a dangerous job for even the most gifted soldier, and Sena, as unlucky as he is, won't make it very far without the procedure.
We can begin with his body enhancement just as soon as the computer malfunction is taken care of. Oh, he tripped! Now he's back up. No, he tripped again. How absolutely hilarious! Sena's a riot!
He is trying his hardest. How can you laugh at him for that?
So how about that blowfish? I know of an excellent spot.
He must really hate you. Even though you're supposed to get the body enhancement operation first, he's making you do the exact same stuff as us.
But yeah, that's the way a person can be about it. At the end of the day, what you do, how you feel about stuff, you have to own that. Regardless of how you got there, what caused it, whatever, on some level you have to acknowledge and own that, and then you find something to do with it. Preferably, something constructive. And not everybody you start with gonna be there in the end or be there at the finish line. Nor should you necessarily trust people waiting at the finish line. That's a story for another time. There's a lot of people that try to pull the wool over people's eyes. They're just waiting for somebody to slip up. And these people want to try to walk around and smile on people's face. Got messed up intent across the board. It's definitely like a poison or a sickness at that point. But what can you do? This idea that, you know, people are saving the world or something by value, pouring something out, some of that need to kind of end a bit, because there's only so much one person can do in so little time, life-wise. Doesn't make it pointless, you just have to really allocate that. Kind of like stat points, like, okay, where are we allocating this? But, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. And I sometimes have to keep telling myself that, because everybody gets sad, everybody gets upset about the things that happen. But you move forward. And before I play this last clip, for the love of God, stop letting other people try to put their responsibilities onto you. What they decided to do with their life is what they decided to do. And whatever podcast monologue they want to be on about, that's what they're on about. I'm happy they handle their responsibilities. I handle mine. Stop trying to provoke someone into making a choice they really shouldn't be making. Not everybody need to make that choice. You can run out there and chase that egg. Not everybody. That concern, I mean, yeah, it's an important thing. Should be, mostly for you. But not everybody dream of that. And if they do acquire that, it'll be in a timely fashion, hopefully. Be a little responsible about that. Take ownership and accountability for how you feel about stuff, but also have enough wherewithal to know time and place. Have a little tact about it. Be a little tactful with it. People really need to humble themselves. No. I digress. Tried to promise myself not to turn this into somewhat of a pseudo rant here, but it's all in good fun. I'm leaving this in there. But yeah. Live your life. Live it well. Do what you can. But most importantly, know the ins and outs of stuff. Protect yourself. Be safe. And if something is deemed far too dangerous to engage in, pump your brakes on it and do something else. Don't go running out there trying to stepping on rattlesnakes and like shoving your arm down a rabbit hole or something. It's just, especially when you know the likelihood of that. All the ilks that come with that. Your choice at the end of the day. Anyway, I hope this video has been able to help a few people. Hell, even if it's just one person that listens to it, or one person that got some out of it, hey, that's good too. It's all that matters. And if you want to voice your thoughts in the comments section or your experience with it, that's cool. You know, if you feel comfortable sharing that, up to you. So be on the lookout for stuff I got planned in the future. Working on getting better. Haven't felt my best. Getting there though. Little by little. little sad right now, but I find a way to heal from that too. Live with your eyes open. Don't worry about who the hell is up or asleep or whatever. Just live with your eyes open, damn the rest. Doesn't need to be a whole entourage thing. It's cool if people want to rock with you like that, but if it's not, then not in the cards. Screw it. Press on. I don't know too many people that have lived their entire life without some form of regret. Regret over what they did, what they didn't do, who they hung out with, who they decided to cut off. That's not always going to be cut and dry. So you have to try to make the best choices that you can. And for me, the older I get, the less I really care too much. Because your peace of mind is very important. It becomes one of the most important things when everything else starts to go. You may not be necessarily satisfied with the way things are, but you have to find some level of being content. Or else everything else will just poison you and damn near drive you mad and piss you off. And there's an element of that too. Pissed off some of this stuff happened, but people handle things in their own way. So anyway, you keep treading along, and hopefully everyone reaches where they need to be. Anyway, take care and peace.
Yeah, I was born and raised here in Shiverpool. Lived here my whole life. It's where they sort the fish. It's the dumbest thing I've ever heard of. But yeah, I worked there just to kind of pacify my mom a little bit. Good old Shiverpool. This place sucks, bro.
I worked my way up from the sardine pile, then to the mackerel pile, and I ended up in the gefilte fish pile. All hard work.
It's not like some I could mention.
Yes, they forgot the kid with the thing on the water.
My house? It's down over there. You see it right there with the surfboards? Yeah, I mean, I just live here with me and my brother Glenn, my mom.
I mean, he's out there in the water all day.
All day.
You know, shirking his responsibilities.
Yeah, shirking.
You know, hatching these eggs is a big responsibility.
Good time, Glenn.
My brother Cody, he just doesn't understand that.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to step up and be a man.
It takes a real man to sit on an egg.
Oh, you know it.
Wednesday, come to daddy.
He wants to be different all the time with the different, or got the time in the day. Only 6 months in a day.
Thanks for making it.
Yeah, sorry, it's just too good to
make. Making it.
Yeah, how was it out there?
He's a big brother, I'm the little brother.
I'm not touching you. Not gonna
Do you
touch
see this?
You.
Don't.
I'm not.
He makes sure that I know that, too. I had to fight for everything. I mean, even mom's tuna casserole, you know?
There we go.
I'm lucky I survived.
It really wasn't that easy for him growing up. Like I said before, he never really knew his father.
I'm not really the person to ask about it, truthfully, because I was just too young to remember. I mean, look, I'm not the only kid on the island whose dad was, you know, eaten.
Still, it had to be traumatic.
No, not for me, bro. Not for me.
What's your dream?
To go away.
To go away. That's great.
Do you guys want a drink?
Gotta run away.
They don't want to drink.
Responsibility and life.
This is unique. This is not the norm.
Dreams.
So,
when is this not happening?
What? Don't make that noise. It's
really disrespectful. I would never do that.
Mm-hmm. You just wouldn't make it out of your mouth.
That's
you know what?
The difference between you and me.
You know what? I can't do this anymore.
Mom, look what you did.
This is for me. This isn't for you. Why is Glenn still here?
Yeah, exactly. Mom!
I don't understand why everybody has to be so judgmental. I understand why Mom's judgmental. I think it's because she cares, partially. I think it's also partially because everyone else is looking at her like, hey, Cody's just a bum. Cody's this, Cody's that, Cody's this. Cody's me, bro. Let me be me. When is that gonna start?
Stay back, guys. I'm the one he wants.
Just stop and think, Kulbara. It's no time for your showmanship. Face Toguro alone now and you'll die before this minute is through.
Hey, Koenma. You risked your life on Urameshi's fight, and now I'm gonna do the same. So make a place for me, and make sure my wake is as good as his.
Kulbara,
There's no stopping him. And if I'm gonna go now, I'm gonna go charging at full speed! A mulberry is a tree, Kulbara is a man, and I'll prove it. We all have to die when our time comes, but if we do our duty, we don't got regrets. So taste a little piece of my sword, Toguro.
Young Joey McEnroe was a beacon for a new generation. May he rest in peace. So, what am I bid for the board? He'll give me 30. He'll give me 30. Come on, 30.
Don't
come on.
Don't touch your stuff, man.
Now, if you want to bid.
Give me that.
Hey, yep.
Hey, hey, everyone. How you been?
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. That's me. Skank, what's happening, man? Got a little sand in your egg sack there, fella.
Where have you been, Z? What happened?
Oh, you know, I got lost for a little while. But that kid there, Cody, he pointed the way back.
Hey, check it out. How about this? You want to talk about talent scout? People find talent. I bring them back from the dead. The now living
Reggie,
legend. Ladies and...
Shut up.
What? Shut up.
I'm not a legend. I'm just a guy looking for some nice waves, some good friends.
Ow.
Hey, guys. Ow. Swell's Hello. Happening over in the North Shore.
I'm right behind you, Z.
Ouch. That hurt. Hey, come back here. You don't walk away. Come on.